I really appreciate being able to share our ministry with you. Pastor Puccio has been a friend of mine since 2007. Maybe that's 2008, but somewhere in that ballpark. And so I'm really grateful to be able to be here. Joyce and I, about 2.5 years ago, went through a missions class. And it was interesting because as we went through the missions class, one passage that really struck us was Matthew 28:19. Go and make disciples of all in all the world, baptizing. And the thing that struck me about that passage was that it didn't specify what kind of career you had or what kind of job you had, but that you went into all the world. You know, the song we sang this morning, Go Tell It to the Mountains. You know, that was really, to me, a perfect song for what Joyce and I are doing. Because what we're doing is, we as careers are not church planters. We're not pastors. We're school psychologists, both of us are. We both work in two different school settings. And we want to go out into Thailand and really all of Southeast Asia to be able to help keep missionaries on the field. The need is so great. We have discovered, as we've been there twice in the last year, there are thousands and thousands of missionary families preaching the gospel to those who are in Southeast Asia, and there's such a need. 95% of Thailand is Buddhist. They do not believe in Jesus Christ as their Savior. They do not have salvation. They will not go into eternity where they need to go. And it breaks my heart that that's happening. What we're finding as missionaries are in Thailand, as they're in Southeast Asia, whether it be in Cambodia, Laos, Vietnam, Burma, all of these countries have these missionaries who are there, and they don't have schools to put their children in. They're church planting, but they don't have schools necessarily in all these locations. There's a few here and there, a few international schools, but the missionaries have children with learning disabilities. Pastor Ken? You certainly know about that. I don't know if you've heard stories that he's shared about some of the children at his school. We've been in many, probably hundreds of meetings together. And you're probably sick of me hearing me talk about executive functioning. but he has, and he makes fun of me. He actually does. He makes fun of me for that, which I think is great. But these children do have problems learning. They can't learn to read. They can't learn to write. They can't learn language as they should. And when that happens to missionaries in a distant area, what are they to do? They don't know how to identify what the problem is. They're not necessarily educators. So they can't go down to the local school, have their child assessed and brought into special courses or have special accommodations put in for their education. So what do? Well, what Joyce and I discovered almost 2 years ago, was that the missionaries in Southeast Asia have nowhere to go, especially in Chiang Mai. Chiang Mai is northern Thailand. That's where we're going to be located. And in Chiang Mai, when we get there, we actually will arrive this January 1st. We leave in 2 weeks from Tuesday, so we're leaving on December 30th. That will be the first two school psychologists in Chiang Mai, Thailand, a city of 500,000 people. There are none. If you were to look in this area right around Riverside, you would probably find 100 school psychologists within a 50-mile radius right here in Riverside. You go to Chiang Mai in Thailand and look in that same radius, there are none right now, not a single one. And we were really burdened by that because we thought, what's happening? And the thing that makes that concerning to us is that for every 5 missionaries that have to go home, and many of them go home because of their children's education, they return to their passport country. For every 5 of them that go home, only one family goes back out. The ratio is not good. So we are seeking to keep missionaries in place in Southeast Asia, throughout all of Asia. And that's really what our mission is. Joyce will be the school psychologist on staff at a school in Chiang Mai, an international school called Grace International School. And we have all kinds of information on our website if you're interested in looking at that. We would love for you to do that. I will be working with the homeschool population in that area, and Joyce and I will also be working with regional schools. We've already been asked to come to a school in Hong Kong, a school in Taipei, Taiwan, and then another school that wants us actually almost frequently in Bangkok. We are also have relationships with schools in Manila and Malaysia, a school called Dalat in Malaysia. And so we are really excited about being able to serve as as missionaries, as school psychologist missionaries, even though we're not church planters, we want to keep missionaries on the field, those who are. So it's so important to us. We have some needs, though. One of the needs that we have two needs. We have prayer needs, we have financial needs. And even though we're only 2 weeks away from going, we haven't quite reached our financial support. So we're also asking for help if that's something that you would prayerfully consider. But the thing we need as much, if not more than anything, is prayer. We would really ask that you would pray for us. And we have prayer cards. I set some prayer cards out at the back. Please feel free to take one. There's a sign up if you would like to sign up for our newsletter and get, we don't send very often, but about every 6 to 8 weeks, we'll send a newsletter updating you on where we're at, what's going on, the kind of ministry that's going on, because we have a lot of exciting things actually in the future. We're developing a relationship and actually have developed a relationship with Cal Baptist University. I don't know if you're familiar with the university here in Riverside, but they have a school psychology department. Joyce and I have been doing mentoring with them for a number of years now. And we are looking to actually be able to offer state-certified hours through their licensure in Thailand. So it's very exciting to be able to provide that for new school psychologists, because we're not getting any younger. We've got, you know, 10, 15, 20 years left to be able to do this. We need to replace ourselves, and that's how we really want to do that. So prayer for that. Prayer for our cultural adjustment. And I think probably the thing that's the closest to Joyce and I's heart is we have two boys, two adult men who are our children here in town. And we also have a 3-year-old grandson. And leaving our family is probably the hardest thing we've ever had to do. Just to be able to hug that little 3-year-old that last time is going to be really tough. So we need prayer for that. That's a hard one. But we would love if you'd follow us. And please feel free, like I said, take a card and pray for us and sign up for our newsletter. Pastor, thank you so much for letting me be able to share this with everybody.